Hello, everybody. Jessie Lockhart here with what I hope to be my first upload. My first just kind of basic playthrough, no stream, just me, the game, and the sound of my voice. That made perfect sense. What a great start. Oh boy, we got a lot to learn, a lot to do before we're gonna make this, maybe not necessarily professional, but at least a pretty decent quality as opposed to what we got now. So I apologize to everybody. This is pretty new to me. But I hope I can make this somewhat entertaining for everyone. This is going to be my first real attempt. I actually played this game quite a bit. As you can see, ooh, we're playing The Binding of Isaac Rebirth, the remake of the hit PC game. And I already have quite a bit of experience with this game, as you will see. Ooh, yeah, we're at the end already. And we're already working on a run in the meantime. And yeah, as you can see here, I've gotten quite a bit of work done with a lot of characters. And I think what I'd like to do is go back to this game here and start it up. And it's basically right from the very beginning. It's just using it to test out the video, test out the sound primarily. And hopefully this sound is coming out good. So why don't we just jump right into it? A knife? A kitchen knife? Sounds pretty ominous. So here we are, The Binding of Isaac. We're playing as Magdalene, my personal favorite of the group, just because she has a lot of health. Infamy, damage reduction. Yet she actually haven't had a lot of success with her overall, but just for safety's sake, yeah, he just like that right there. Oh boy. It begins already. My lack of focus. These guys are pretty easy, and they're actually not really shooting at all, which is interesting. Maybe I'm not close enough? No? Yeah, these guys... Something happened there, and they usually spit little balls of blood out of their necks. Yeah, that sounds amazing, doesn't it? Yeah, one thing you'll quickly find if you're not familiar with this game at all is a very cartoony kind of humor involved. Oh, crap. I knew that was going to happen. These guys are smarter than they look. They're very clever. And I am not. I'm better than this. I know it. I gotta work on it. But one thing you'll learn quickly about this game is its style, its sort of sense of humor, as it likes to use, for one, a lot of biblical references, and two, also just, you know, the concept of cartoony violence and gore. There's a lot of blood and guts in this game. I don't think you really got to see it in the previous room. Yeah, those guys didn't really, those guys didn't die in any sort of a hardcore fashion. Maybe this guy's. Not just blood. How about you? Ooh, I lost track of you. Now, one thing you may notice right away is there's a similarity of this game between this and The Legend of Zelda. And I'm pretty confident that was a game that inspired this game. So you got stuff like locked doors requiring keys, you have bombs that can blow up blocks, and even walls. In fact, why don't we see if we can find what's referred to as the secret room, and here it is. The secret room is usually just a place where you can pick up a few consumables, which are basically, as you can see on the left, are coins, bombs, and keys. There's also hearts, tarot cards, and pills. Those kind of stuff give you a little boost for a room, or give you some kind of a benefit, or some kind of a detriment, actually. Something negative. Pills are amazing that way. Well, let's use this key and see what we get. Ooh, interesting. That's a good opportunity to use the M heart, which is what Magdalene starts with. Basically, instantly gives her a heart back upon usage. Oh, man. It's good choices here. This is Book of Revelations. We can use this to give ourselves a soul heart, which is a means of getting extra health beyond our normal heart containers. Much like The Legend of Zelda, there are heart containers. And the way you get more is by pickup items similar to these that basically just say HP up. And you can never go above that. Spirit hearts let you go above that, though. Let you get more health that way. And heart containers are added and taken away just constantly throughout the run of a game. And this game is really random. And I mean very random. Because I got that battery there. I think we'll save that for later for something if we need it. I believe there are similar games this is, you might consider, like something like Smash TV or, there's another game. Someone mentioned, particularly, Paul of Paul's Gaming and Piece of Pie Software, who I first discovered this game from, and I watch a lot of his runs on the game. But I believe he made some mention of a particular game this kind of resembles. But I believe the actual genre is roguelike, which is... I have to look up the definition of that. But here we go. As you can see here, we're already halfway into the boss fight with Famine, one of four horsemen you can fight. Although technically there's five, because there's also the Headless Horseman. But there's famine, there's pestilence, there's war and death. You can fight each one of them. But whether or not you're going to fight each one of them, or even one of them at all, is, again, just completely random. Ball bandages. A little orbital. Basically, it just helps with blocking projectiles, and I believe it actually does some damage if an enemy touches it. And there are all sorts of little orbitals and familiars and all sorts of stuff you can acquire throughout the run of the game. And yeah, like the boss, the items you pick up, the placements of the dungeons, what you can find in dungeons, the shops, items, all of that stuff is randomized in this game. And you can very easily, you know, let's go back. I just realized the Book of Revelations back here, which gives us a spirit heart. I can use that again by picking up the book, the battery, which gives us full recharge, use the book, and we get another soul heart. And that's real quick to explain the way usable items work is basically once they're used, their charge is down to zero, and each room you clear of enemies gives you a charge. As you can see, this one requires only three charges, so if we face three enemy rooms, we'd recharge back to full. And each level's pretty much the same. You go through each room, trying to find the boss, beat the boss, and then move on down to the next room, where the ultimate goal is to fight Mom. I should probably get into the meat of the game, the story. You see here, Magdalene experiencing what are technically dreams that Isaac is supposed to be experiencing. Oh, that's fun. Curse of Darkness. Another random thing you can get is a random effect on the room, so it's really dark in here. Barely see anything. Oh boy, I think right away we're gonna use this. The Book of Belial. Because we got three enemies in here that just generate other enemies. And we're gonna a little late on that. And it can get really crazy with enemies like this. The way they just spawn more and more enemies. Oh crap! I did not notice you. Nice, good job. Ow, ow. But I think that worked out alright. So the story of the game is pretty straightforward, although it hardly seems straightforward when you think about it. It's kind of twisted. Basically, you have Isaac and Isaac's mom. Isaac loves to play with his toys, and he likes to draw. And Isaac's mom likes to watch Christian broadcasting. Now one day, Mom gets a message from God saying, Isaac is evil, so you need to do things to make him not evil. So she starts by taking his toys away, taking his pens and crayons and all that stuff so he can't draw away. And then, you know, God says, that's not enough. And then she takes his clothes away and then locks him in his room. And then said, oh, that's not enough. You have to kill Isaac. You have to sacrifice him. Isaac catches word of this. And he jumps into a trap door underneath his room and ends up here in the basement. Actually, currently, we're in the cellar, which is one of... Basically, there are divisions of levels. You go to different places. You start off in the basement or the cellar, and then you go down to the caves and other such places from there on. But basically, Isaac goes into the basement and then has this little adventure. Sounds real simple, right? Maybe too simple. Okay, we currently have... Ooh, we have one key. Now immediately, I want to use this key to go into the item room and get a new item. Ooh, I don't think I've gotten this one yet. Although this, just immediately you can tell because of the black lines and the blue outline, that this is one of the zodiac sign items you can pick up. Aquarius, Trail of Tears. Now my guess is the way this one works is basically it's referred to as something called blood creep, which basically leaves a damaging kind of thing on the ground, whether it be a pool or a trail, something like that. And there are tons of enemies that actually drops this and you walk over and you get hurt. Well, you can get stuff like this yourself where you can actually hurt enemies that way. And I'm gonna guess that because it's called Trail of Tears, it basically means that the damage it's gonna do is based on the damage your tears do. Now you can see here, we have a whole bunch of stats here. We have underneath the paws, we have a boot, we have some arrows, we have a sword, a bow and arrow, what looks like a bullet, and then it's actually a three-leaf clover, even though I believe it's supposed to be a four-leaf clover. But basically in that order is speed, tears, or shot, and that's based on essentially how many shot you have, or how good your tears are, I believe. Next up is damage, then you have range, then you have, I believe that's actually shot, that's the speed of your shot, or firing rate. Either the arrows or the bullet, one or the other, is basically either how many tears you're firing and how fast you're firing them. And then the last one, of course, is luck. And over on the left, you can see some strange letters. That's basically what's referred to as a seed, and what that is basically you can replay this whole scenario. Everything that's, all the items that come up, all the bosses that come up, the rooms as they are, all of that is just seeded, and you can play that any time you want. The only problem, though, is it doesn't work like a save feature. It's just basically, oh, you like that? How that run went? Oh, you can play it again. But by doing so, you can't earn any trophies or any unlockables. Sucks. If you want to do it, you gotta do it in one run. Now, you can always exit the game and then come back and continue. There's no problem with that. But you can't actually save your progress. You have to do it all in one specific run. Not necessarily one sitting, but you start this run, you gotta finish in that run to get, if you want to get special stuff. And then just underneath that, you can see my stuff. All the stuff that Isaac, or the character you're playing as, has collected. Alright, let's move on. I didn't get to touch on this real quick. One of the other randomizer things that you can have is a specific level that you're on, like this I'm currently on. Let's just look it up. Cellar 2, which is the alternative to the basement. You can get one or the other, and you can actually play both the cellar and the basement, playing one and then the other. But you get... Sometimes you'll get some kind of added effects to them that affect the level itself. In this case, it's Curse of Darkness, where basically there's very little light. That's one of the least affecting things that you can get. It's not so bad. But then you have ones like Curse of the Unknown. I believe what that does is basically it removes your heart count. And I think it even removes your item and... its recharge count. It doesn't actually physically remove it, it just doesn't show it to you. It removes it from the HUD, basically. Curse of the Blind, you don't get to see what the special items are, it's just a big question mark. You have no idea, you're basically guessing. Alright, looks like we're ready to go face the boss. And as you notice over to the right, you got a pill. Let's see it. You see the question marks, you have no idea what it is. And this is the case for every run. You don't get to find out what the pill is until you've used it. And hey, I got speed up. That's a good thing for Magdalene, because she starts off with low speed. And yeah, you have all sorts of other random effects that can happen in a dungeon that's going to affect it. And sometimes you can even get, like, just right off the bat, even in the first level, you can get just some crazy enemies and some elites or... I forget what they're called specifically, but I kind of think of them as an elite version. They're basically a very special version of the enemy they represent, which you actually saw earlier. Those guys chasing me around, they actually cornered me. Alright, so we're going to go face the boss. Tally-ho! Pin. It's kind of a... it's not the funnest fight. It's because it's one of those where you're basically just waiting. Because he'll do that a lot. But when he pops up, you just pop him a bunch of times. Oh, one thing I forgot to do! Book of Belial. So what the Book of Belial does is give you a boost up in damage. It also does something very fun, which is kind of an important effect. Ooh. What did that do? Ooh, increase my damage and my range. I love it. I lost the speed, though, but that's okay. So one thing you get at the end of a boss fight, if you meet a certain requirement, and I forget if it's whether or not you take damage on an entire floor or level, or if it's if you don't take damage in a boss fight. If you don't take damage for the whole thing, then you're guaranteed for sure, but I believe it's either damage for the level or damage for the boss fight, and that's based on your red hearts. You can take suffer spirit hearts, there's also black hearts you can get. You can suffer damage that way. But if you lose a red heart, you're not guaranteed. You're probably not going to get it. But there's two things you can get. You can get what's referred to as the deal with the devil, or you can get a blessing. And basically what it is a door pops open, and it's either a white door, that looks all nice, holy, and radiant, or it's a black door with a, as you can see, a devil-like motif to it, and it's dark. Let's go in, shall we? And as you can see, yeah, very spooky. You got a big Satan statue here. And you got three chests. Let's open them up. Oh, no. That's what we call troll bombs. They pop up, and they go boom. And that's all they do. They hurt you. Simple. And spiders. Oh, the devil, you bastard. You bastard. Oh, what the... I guess I missed a spider. The Curse of Darkness actually got me in this case. Now, normally, and I'm hopefully we're going to get to see it later on, when you come into the deal with the Devil Room, there will be items on display here. And they'll also have a little heart underneath them. And basically what that is you can take that item at the cost of one of your heart containers. Or multiple heart containers, if it shows. Most of them will only take a single heart container. But it, like, permanently lowers your health. You can always get higher health, but... it's not that common. It really kind of depends on the items you have access to, really. Okay, so we've looked all this place over. There's really nothing more we can do. We have no keys. We can't access either of those two shops up there. We could see what's in the, I believe it's called the cursed room. Essentially what it is, you take damage going in and take damage going out, so you effectively lose a whole heart. It can be replenished, but... Oh, no, that's actually a boss rush room. And there's special rooms like this where basically... you go in, you get the item, and then suddenly it's like basically a rush. Most of the time it's just basic enemies, but when you got a big skull right here, that's a boss rush. And you face two, maybe three bosses from the game in a row. Pretty hardcore. I think even if it was open, I don't think I would want to do it. I'd like to have the Book of Belial available in order to use it, get that damage boost. Nothing more we can do here. Screw you, devil. You screwed me out of something good. And we're going to go down. Yeah, if you get the chest from the devil room, it's most of the time bad. And that was a fun, pleasant image. Curse of the Blind. Uh-oh. So, I mentioned the Curse of the Blind before. We have no idea what the items are. No idea. Before I tackle that, I want to fight a few enemies in the rooms right now. Ow, ow. That was gonna be bad. There we go. God damn. Yeah, I'm not very skilled. I've had maybe about 100 runs with this game. I think that's a pittance in comparison to some people who play this game. And I've only just started with Rebirth. I've never played the original. Oh, wow. They just homed in on me. Damn. I had, like, no chance. No chance at all. And I lost my opportunity to go in there. Great. Thanks, guys. Appreciate it. Oh, and of course. Oh, man. Wow. That sucks. So there's not even anything in this room. This game just does that to you sometimes. You think you're making a sacrifice for something good. Oh, a key. A key is good, actually. Unfortunately, we have no idea what the hell this is. And sometimes, you'll pick up an item and you actually don't want it. It either depends on your own personal playthrough style, or it doesn't synergize with anything you have. Sticky babies. Okay. I believe that spawns spiders. I'm not 100% sure, though. I think effectively if you take damage, it spawns spiders. Or maybe it's only when enemies are near or something like that. Not 100% sure. I think I've gotten the item before, never really cared for it. These things spawn stuff, though. They spawn... boom. Yeah, they do. Okay. Every time you beat an enemy, spawn spiders. I had a feeling that was the case. Oh, boy. So on top of stuff like the Four Horsemen, randomly, in some levels, you could end up facing one of the seven deadly sins. Nice. What'd I get? The virus. That's what I figured. So now, any enemy that touches me, they're gonna get poisoned. Ha 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 ha. Sucks for you. Of course, it also sucks for me, because they hit me. They did damage to me, and that's not good. Good range, good range. Like it. Let's kinda jump in and out here. With that. One, let their bullets spread out a bit, give you a nice wiggle room. And, yeah, honestly, this game has quite a learning curve, I think. Just, one, figuring out the mechanics of how your character works, which you can move in all eight directions, diagonals, up and down, left and right. However, you can only shoot in plus pattern. You can only shoot up, down, and left and right. The only case that can change is there are some tier items you can get that affect how your tier shot is. Like you get multiple shots, or it can do something weird, like have your tiers hover around you. Yeah. There's even a pill you can get that actually reverses how you can fire your tiers, and it shoots diagonal instead of horizontally or vertically. There's a word for that, I just can't think of it. Yeah, essentially you do like what these guys are doing right now. We got keys. Keys are good. No way to get to those coins because we don't have bombs. Oh no, we do have bombs. We have a bomb, but I'd rather not use that bomb just for one coin. It's not really worth it. Alright, we continue on, and hey, here is the boss room. Now, before I go in, let's see here. Oddly enough, I haven't come across a shop yet. I think we should rectify this. Actually, you know what? Let's wait. Let's fight the boss first. And then we'll see. Pestilence, another horseman. We've got two so far. Kinda makes me wonder, are we gonna see war and death? We very well could. Ah, I hate this guy. Oh, always forget. And that's bad. See, that's the booming tier I mentioned before. If you're within its vicinity, it functions a lot like a bomb. And something just popped up there. What? I think I know what it is. I'm gonna pick it up. The small rock. Yeah. Damage up. That was incredibly lucky, but that was not. I gotta survive this fight here. And down you go. Alright. Again, no idea what that is. Let's find out. Oh, another ball of bandages. Awesome. Now, most items you cannot stack. But there's actually a couple items that you get. And it's mainly two orbitals, the ball of bandages, and the cube of meat. And you can stack them three times. First time, you just get an orbital. And it's literally what it says it is. In this case, it was a big old ball of bandages, first aid bandages. Or Band-Aids. Actually, I think that's a brand name. I remember a Clerks joke about that. I believe it was the Clerks animated series, specifically. Don't call it Band-Aids, that's the brand name. You call it Adhesive Strip. Anyway, the second one you get the Band-Aid Girl, I believe, or the Bandage Girl. Or you get her head anyway, and she basically shoots tears with you. The next one you get, she actually becomes a walking around familiar, and I believe she just outright attacks people. The cube of meat does same thing, becomes Meat Boy, Super Meat Boy. As obviously a reference to the game Super Meat Boy. So we get another boss room, which is what the Book of Belial is meant to do. Every time you use it in a boss room and kill the boss, you automatically, you are guaranteed to get the Devil Room. Or actually the Heavenly Room. I'm not sure what it's called though. I think Sanctuary or something. Oh no! Not good. Ah yes. And as you can see, he... Oh crap. Forgot that little detail. See, I could have used this against him. Really could have used this, but damage is going good right now. We really like the damage. But I believe the tears she is firing are charm tears. Basically, I don't think it's guaranteed every time they hit, but basically what that means is they kind of become your ally. If you're the only, if they're the only enemy though, they'll still attack you anyway. But if they're multiple enemies, they'll start turning on their buddies, which is pretty cool. And there's all sorts of little effects like that. Like, you might have noticed during the Lust fight that she had a little snail on, that the Lust had a little snail on top of their head. I think it was a she. Might be a he, I'm not sure. But basically, that meant that they were slow. And there's other stuff like fear and poison. And I think that's it, but there might be more. Alright, let's see what we got from Krampus. Krampus Rage. Yep, the head of Krampus. And basically that plus pattern attack he did, you basically get that. And I think late game I'd really love to have that. But it's kind of early and I want more deals with the devil because I actually have a lot of health. Or I have a lot of heart containers to give up. I actually don't have a lot of health. I'm kind of screwed right now. As great as Krampus' head is, Book of Belial I think is just slightly better for me. In this case. I think I'm thinking long term. Instead of short term. But let's just show you what it does. Lots of slowdown too. It is a lag inducer. As well as a four-way shot. And it's actually a really good weapon for the fight against Mom. So you see that boss room door, there's four of them when you fight Mom, and basically there are parts of her that are popping out of those. And you, if you're lucky and all four of them have a piece of Mom sticking out of it, you can get all four at the end and just do massive damage. It's like she doesn't even stand a chance. And here's our first item room. Our first, the first one we could ever visit. It's crazy. That can happen in this game, where you just don't get enough keys, you don't have enough money, so it's not worth going. And here we go, we have no idea what this is. This could be a really bad pickup, I could be wasting it, let's find out. Mom's key, we like it. That is very good. We get more keys out of it, and I believe there's an added effect to it as well. I can't think of it though. Anyway, there's this guy, he's a shopkeeper. He does nothing. He doesn't even talk. You can blow him up, actually, with a bomb. And the donation box is kind of cool. You can just dump coins in it, like this. And it holds those coins over for every single run you have of this game. And anytime you're like kind of short on, you know, getting a pill or a battery or a key or something, you just drop a bomb and you get the money back. Let's just show you for funsies' sake. I'll blow him up in the process. Ah, spiders. Of course. Spideys! And as you can see, it was at 114, it's now at 111. And I don't know if it gave us two coins, though, which was interesting. I guess one got lost. It fell in the machine. It's no longer available. Or that might be the cost of actually doing it that way. Is my guess. But we have one bomb left. This just want to go over here and see if this is even open. I doubt it would even go in there. Yep, it's not. So, no, there's no way it could be there. I mean, the best possibility is the secret room is here. And it is. Good guess. Ah, it's a slot machine. Let's try our luck. Hearts are on order today. Hearts are in demand, and oh yeah. So far, so good. Nope. One more. Nope. Aww. And we're out of bombs. Otherwise, we could bomb this thing and get some money back. And maybe a few other things. Maybe get some hearts or some bombs or keys or something. Always good. Actually, if we had more bombs, we could just bomb the other side. And then come out the other end. Instead of going the long way around. Alright, so we are done with this floor. There's nothing more that we can really do. And the boss room is still... Because Krampus' head is still in there. But we're not going to take it. We like the Book of Belial. Because we want more feature deals with the devil. And honestly, in terms of playing this game and being... And Curse of Darkness again! Jeez, you're getting everything today. Basically... In order to really beat the game, or to do really well in the game, deals with the devil are pretty important because you get some pretty damn good stuff from them. Including that is a beautiful bounty. I love it. Alright, bats. Not normally a bad enemy. They fly, but they... Oh, they charge. They're aggressive. Okay, and there's another type of item we can get in this game called trinkets. And I'm going to regret getting that. Eh, that's not so bad, actually. There's one type of trinkets in this game that are worms. And basically what they do is they change the effect of your shot. In this game, this is the wiggle worm, and it basically gives your tier shots a wave pattern. Similar to the wave beam in Super Metroid, for example. Or maybe, I don't swear there's like a wave kind of shot in something like Contra, or just a whole variety of side-scrolling shooters. This is not so bad. These guys are manageable. Just kind of try to avoid these shots here. I kind of like this effect. Oh, that was dumb. Ran right into it. I kind of like that effect on those guys. There are three types of those guys. And actually, that's kind of the case for a number of enemies. There are several types that you can run into. They do different things as you go. But those guys, they have the original ones, actually have an eye, and they shoot a straight shot. Those guys are blind. They don't have eyes. And they shoot a spread shot. And then you have another type later on that have their eyes just completely bloodied, and they shoot a similar stream shot like you saw with Krampus. Now you might be wondering, what are these guys? Well, for one, I think they're a bit of a nod to the gel enemy? I think that's what they were called. From Legend of Zelda. However, these guys, those guys you just saw, were basically poop. Literally poop. I don't like these guys. Die, jeez. Wow, that's a lot of hit points. There you go. So these guys, I don't like. I don't like their enemy type. Main reason being is because you gotta wait on them. You can't hurt them until they expose themselves. And there's one that walks around, and there's been a couple cases where I've been in really bad rooms. Where I got tons of stuff coming at me, the only way to get to just finish the room is to beat those type of enemies. And they just take forever to open up. Wow, getting these kind of guys pretty early. I don't know if I'm getting so soon. Yeah, watch. You see? Yeah, a little snail icon appears before him because he's slowed. Thanks to this thing. That thing's pretty multifaceted. Spawning spiders and causing a slow trail. I like it. Alright, we got another pill that we have no idea what it does. Let's check it out. Oh, that's bad. Health down. So that's one less heart container. We had 6, now we have 5. Wonderful. Now that's the thing about the pills. Above anything else, they are the most random and the most uncertain of what you're going to get. It's really 50-50, although sometimes it seems like it's less than that. And the thing is, they change all the time. Like, you know, that blue pill on this one is health down. It could be a health up in a future game, or a health up in a previous game. It really depends. It's all random. Like I said, that's a common word you're going to be hearing a lot in this. Here we have mini bush. Fun item. Speed up, range up, and we're tiny! We're like chibi versions of ourselves, even though we're already a chibi version to begin with. We're even chibier than before. It's amazing. And more spideys. Great. I just love spiders. Truth be told, actually. Ugh, serious arachnophobia. Especially when I was a kid. Living in a basement converted into a room, though, does expose you to the little bastards on a regular basis. I mean, just walking down my steps into my room, there's at least, like, you know, maybe 2 or 3 just kind of hanging in the corners. And I don't mind, they're just daddy long legs, they're not so bad. Every occasion I might get something else. Those are the ones that worry me. Just in case they're particularly poisonous. But it's not so bad. It's allowed me to actually kind of help get over my fear. I don't mind them so much just being around, actually. For one, it gets rid of any moths that pop up, any flies that happen to pop up, which is a big deal during the summer. Oh, I'm back here already. I didn't realize I looped around. So, this is locked. Let's open it up and take a peek. I forget what that does. It gets us more pills, I believe. Ooh, we are one shy of getting a spirit heart. That's okay. We'll come back. Almost guaranteed to get more money between now and then. Yeah, here you go. The same guys I mentioned before that shoot a straight shot. Well, semi-straight. And dead. Yeah, you'll get something like this. A hazard spikes, take a full heart. And sometimes you'll just hide these things right behind them. It's like, yeah, you want this? Take damage. I dare you. The game just loves to punish you just for playing it. It's like, oh, you want to play me? Here you go. Here's a mass load of enemies that are going to kill you right away. Ha 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 ha. That teases you for playing me. It's weird. It really is that way. I think I was talking about something else in particular, but I lost my train of thought. Happens a lot. Something about hearts and pills. Yeah, I'm trying to remember if that... I think it just gets you a bunch of pills. But it might actually increase your odds of getting pills, too. Something along those lines. So we got the boss room. Kind of want that spirit heart right now, and I don't think the odds of us getting more coins from the boss are likely. Let's check something here. Yeah, there's a good chance. another good guess. I'm 3 for 3 here. And hey, look, more coins. Money, money, money. So, at that point, I don't think it's worth it to check that other room. We got money. We don't want to risk taking more damage. Look how happy Bandage Girl is right there. She's so happy. She loves it. She loves her head floating around you and defending you. Alright. So here we go. It's boss time. Gertie. A sick mound of flesh is all he is. Yeah, watch that. Oh, watch out, watch out, watch out. What's up, dude? It reminds me of the Cartman blob from that episode of South Park. The Trapper Keeper episode. We are Trapper Keeper. We are one. Which I think itself was a bit of an homage to, might have been an homage to Akira. I know the scene where Rosie O'Donnell gets crushed within Cartman's mass is a nod to Akira. Towards the end when was it Tetsuo? Yeah, I think it was Tetsuo starts losing control of his power and starts turning into just a big old flesh ball. Really creepy. And we get... Well, what is this? The magic scab. Ooh, money. Ooh, we get health. We get luck up, too. Cool. And hey, look, we didn't get a deal with the devil this time. We got this. Which is interesting. So we got the halo. Very good item. Boosts up all our stats. Gives us extra health. Now, there's a certain point where you can do this. I tried this like the first time I got in this room and nothing happened. You have to reach a certain point, I think. You have to unlock something in particular. But basically... Ooh, do I want to do it now or do I want to try and recharge my item? Let's do it. Basically, you bomb this statue and... You summon an angel. And he's not happy with you. How dare you! Now why- ooh, wow. Thank you. Now the question is, why would you do this? What possible reason would you have to tick this angel off? Ooh, it's shooting at me. That thing is shooting at me. It doesn't like me. Yeah, there's some fire- campfire, fire pits, whatever you want to call them, that actually shoot fireballs at you. It's really mean. Alright, 2 of clubs. That's going to boost up our bombs. That basically gives us double what we already had. And then we get key piece. A piece of a key. And it just floats around us and does nothing. Boop! That was worth it. Especially if I get a... Oh, no spirit heart. Hey, but we got a spirit art here. We love it. Make up for the spirit art we lost. And there's a heart waiting right here for us. And that's pretty much it with this floor. We are going to move on. Now that key piece is important based on certain factors. You basically have to take a certain path in this game. And there's Curse of the Unknown, as I mentioned before. I have no idea how many hearts I have. And I'm not going to try and stop the footage and take a look back just to confirm. But I'm going to guess I had 4 hearts and a spirit heart. Just guessing here. I'm going to go in here. Oh, you bastard! I'm trying to go in here to recharge my item, and you throw... Another... Ah, damn you. You throw another deadly sin at me. This time it's pride. Pride? I think. I'm trying to remember what it was. So this is another trinket. I think all it really does is, I believe it changes regular chests into red chests, which have higher rewards but also have a higher odds of giving you bad stuff like spiders. I think we're okay with the way, and we lost our chance. That's twice that's happened. Damn. Done the luck. Done. Go figure. And yeah, like I said, this is poop. These are giant poops. Giant sentient poops. It's shit demons. I forget what they were called. I forget what they were called in Dogma. Well, that's more or less what they are. It's a construct of poop. Dang it. I wasn't fast enough on that. These guys are annoying. They drop and they turn to those flesh mounds. If you don't destroy that mound, they just keep coming at you. They are relentless. And it's really bad early on if you do not have... If you're not dishing out enough damage or you don't have a high enough fire rate to take them out quick enough. So we were short a heart container. Or we were had an empty heart container, so that doesn't worry me a whole lot. I think that just basically meant that container's filled now. I'm guessing we've used up the spare heart. Because it got hit twice. It just depends on how much damage that that previous guy did to me. Alright, we're going to open this up. And if I remember correctly, this is a dice roll room. I think four. I don't want to touch four. Basically, each number for that room, if you walk on that that dice motif, it does something different based on the number, and it just rerolls stuff. It'll reroll enemies, it'll reroll the dungeon layout, I think, it'll reroll the items you're carrying, it'll reroll the items in the room. It does all kinds of strange stuff based on the number that's on the floor. And ultimately, I think six is the worst in that case, where if you got a really bad setup, then maybe it's good to reroll your items, but if you actually got something good going, which I do here, I kind of like my setup. I got a lot of damage going. Actually, how much? Yeah, pretty good damage, actually. And, ooh, the Bible track, Faith Up. Does some of their added little effect, but no. I like the Wiggle Worm. Let me get Big Daddy Poop here. I don't know what it's called. The little baby poops. Beat him. He turns into charging poops. Poops that charge ya for some reason. And when they die, they turn into baby poops. And they're just so cute. I mean, the cutest sound when you hit him. And they, I swear to God, they look like Hershey's Kisses. And if that disturbs you, you're like, right, now I can't eat the Hershey's Kisses anymore because of that, then my job is done. I have succeeded. And just simply grossing you out. And I got hit. I deserve that. Alright. So we have keys. Let's use them. Ooh, so we got the Bible here. I believe that's what that is. Bible is another usable item. Pretty much all the books you can get are usable items. And essentially what this one does is it gives you flight, which is pretty cool. I don't really have a need for it. I just realized I don't think I've found the item room yet. We need to change that. But another thing the Bible does is that it will instantly kill mom. That boss fight with mom I mentioned earlier, it will instantly kill her when you use it. Pretty hardcore. Which is interesting, too, when you think about it. Can't take that heart yet. We're all filled up on health. She's big into Christian broadcasting. She's very devout Christian. Oh, here they are. These are the guys I mentioned. Those guys are bad. They hurt a lot. But yeah, big into Christian broadcasting. She's very devout Christian. But it's like reading her the Bible is a bad thing. It's interesting. Like, it hurts her. Not entirely sure why that is. Alright, what do we got here? It's the $3 bill, Rainbow Tears. Okay. I don't think we can see what they'll do, actually. Because of the way our tears are, but basically one of the items we had that turn our tears completely red like this, which are blood tears, completely overwrites stuff like that. But effectively what the rainbow tears I believe are supposed to do is it goes through the color spectrum of basically status effect tears, like what you see Bandage Girl's head shooting out. The charm tears. And it just randomly picks one. So you can shoot a poison tear 1 second, you can shoot a slow tear the next. It's interesting. But yeah, I'm not entirely sure if we're actually going to be able to do it. If that's actually going to take effect. Get that heart for safety's sake. Especially since we don't know how much health we have. I'm still thinking we got a lot of heart containers. I think we have a total of 5. So basically 5 hits. Let's do it. Or that's 3 of the 4 horsemen so far. With death being the last. Oh, and yeah, this is a favorite thing war likes to do. That's basically summon troll bombs. He also likes to do this a lot. Which I don't know why. It's just funny, he just flies across the room and doesn't really do anything. You can easily avoid him. Get away from me. Come on, dude. Oh, yeah. I love that face. That is so cute. It's so classic. But you have a god, or like the avatar of war, essentially, making a cute little face like that. And we got, like I said, another ball of bandages, and we now have Bandage Girl. And she still shoots, and I think she attacks people. I believe she does damage to enemies. And we got yet another holy room. Ooh, I haven't seen this one. A shield. You unlocked Forgotten Horseman. Trinity Shield, you feel guarded. Ooh. Interesting. So basically have a shield protecting you, potentially, I believe, against... I'm going to assume that protects you against... Are those my special tears? I'm going to have to look that up to see what this particular item does. Let's see. How my stats? Well, my range is through the roof. I don't need any more range boosting. So I'll keep that in mind. So yeah, I think we're good to go. We could try to find the secret room. But no, we're just going to move on. We don't want to take too long. Alright, we're moving on. Acropolis 2. So I believe we're at a point where the next fight we have is against Mom herself. The fight I mentioned, where you fight just basically pieces of her. It's effectively like a hand or an eyeball or her foot. Try to come after you and attack you. She's calling at you. Isaac! Even though technically we're Magdalene. Ooh, we're facing a boss right now. Oh, it looks like Rainbow Tears are in effect right now. Interesting. Yo. Yes, I think they're in effect, because obviously the color's changing. Whoa. Oh, whoa, did that do what I think it did? I think it did. Or actually, no, it's the, never mind. I'm getting ahead of myself. I believe that's a fear effect. Got him. It's this he's bumping into. He can't clear gaps, chasms, or anything, or pits, or anything like that. Because Isaac can't. These guys can't fly. Isaac can't fly normally. So, what only makes sense in most cases. Yeah, he's really put himself into a bad spot, actually. There's nothing he can do. And we get a bit of money. And we move on to the next room. And hey, we found the item room. Cool. I don't like those guys. Thank you for killing them. Those skeletons can be really annoying. They throw bones at you, and those bones come really fast. You gotta be quick. I believe this is a good one. You have been blessed. It gives you something good. I can't remember what, though. We're feeling pretty holy right now. It's pretty interesting. And it appears we had more heart containers than we thought before. I was kind of prepping for... Ooh, wow. Scythe. Scythe tears. I don't know what causes that. That's interesting. I'm not sure what tier upgrade you get that turns your tears into that, aside from the rainbow tears. But it's pretty damn cool when you think about it. I got this, I don't know what those are doing. These are charm tears, I believe. Purple. Pretty purple. What kind of tears our friend Bandage Girl is shooting at? Alright, we're gonna go down. And then to the right. But when we hate. Oh, that's a bad room. Whew, just barely navigated it. I see. So that's the effect of the rainbow tears, essentially. I guess if they don't give you an effect, they're just going to give you this thing, the blood. So these guys are annoying. Oh, I paralyzed him. Nice. I paralyzed that guy's projectile, too. That's pretty awesome. I like it. Oh, I got myself caught there. Yeah, I'm not doing very good. Look at the draw. That does something with the tarot cards, I believe, but I'm not 100% sure. Alright. These guys aren't good. As you get further in the game, you encounter a lot of enemies that just blasting you with all sorts of stuff. And often, like, shooting something at you when they die. Pretty obnoxious, but I guess that's the best way to dictate an increase in difficulty. I don't think I really want the piggy bank. I definitely want the spirit heart, though. Alright. Go to the right, check out this room. Yeah, not a lot we can do here, because there's spikes everywhere, and they do a lot of damage. And, oh, hey, it's the boss room. We got our item room, we got our shop. The only thing else we could find is the secret room, but we're not going to bother. Alright, so here we go. This is going to be the fight with Mom. Alright. And it always starts with Mom dropping her foot like that. Now, I believe... Yeah, she shows different colors. Like, or different tints or hues. And depending on the hue... Oh, no. There it is. Like, depending on the hue, it depends on what she's going to do specifically. And I think this one, I originally thought all she really does is summon enemies. But I think in this case, she's actually dropping, which basically meant she would never seemingly drop her foot down on you. But I think that proves not to be the case this time. Yep, there she is. And there's actually a mode where she's, where the tint is red. And down goes Mom. Alright. So pick up a heart, pick up spirit heart. And this is the negative. Fate chosen. So I believe at this point there's like two different items you can pick up, and essentially all it does is it unlocks a particular boss fight depending on where you end up going. And I believe the negative is when you reach a certain point you want to go down, which would basically be another trapdoor. Or there's a light that shines down, and basically you can go up and ascend. And that I believe is the photo. Or the Polaroid. Which I don't think I've even unlocked that yet. But here's our deal with the devil. And here's, finally, we get to see what I was talking about. An item with a heart next to it. And none of these are appealing, to be honest. They do highlight something, though, that I hadn't mentioned yet. It hadn't really come up yet, but there are some items that you can pick up that let you... Oh, I didn't want to do that. Oh well. I have it now. I may just pick this one up too. For funsies. But effectively... there's some items you can pick up. If you pick up three or more of that particular item, items based on that particular sort of synergy. Like, for example, I have an item that spawns spiders. I believe if I picked up another two or three more items that spawned spiders or flies, I could become what's the Lord of the Flies. Basically a floating head, I believe. It spawns a bunch of spiders. And in this case, what I got was Guppy's tail. This is Guppy's paw. There's an item called Guppy's head. Yeah, like I said, morbid stuff here. Guess what Guppy's head does? Spawns flies. Anyway, you pick up three or more of Guppy items, you become Guppy. And it's kind of a fun little thing. You get some added benefits. And like, for example, as Guppy, you can just fly. A cat that flies for no reason whatsoever. So we got Guppy's paw here. Which, what it effectively does is, it's going to turn my whole heart containers into spirit hearts. Soul hearts. And in some cases it might be a good thing, sometimes that might be a bad thing. In this case, I don't feel compelled to do it. I like having these hearts. I can always refill them. With spirit hearts, you can't. And basically, it just takes away my heart containers. So I pick it up, I'm going to lose one. If I use it, I'm going to lose one, gain a spirit heart. And that's ultimately going to put me down to three heart containers. If I decide to use this multiple times, yeah. I think in the end, it could end up being really, really bad for me if I do that. But I like having a lot of these hearts. And we have a good means of getting a deal with the devil, guaranteed. So I think we're okay on that. We don't need a buttload of soul hearts to suck up damage and ensure a deal with the devil for us. We've got an item that does that automatically for us. And more guys like to spit a lot of crap at you. These guys, fortunately, you can hit. You don't have to wait for them to expose themselves before you can hit them. And yay, more guys that shoot the beams at you. Those guys are fun, aren't they? Awesome little sound effect, too. And the beam effect is just really cool. And it does I think with the, not in the case of Isaac slash character you play as, Magdalene in this case, it'll only do just the one hit. You do get the, your brief little invulnerability frame. That's a cool shield. I like it. Hey, another boss. But in the case of, if you're a player using said item, nice job, Bandage Girl, nice job. You actually do damage over time. And it's Tammy's Head, reusable tear burst. Effectively what Tammy's Head does is it shoots out tears just literally like a burst. Kind of similar to the way you saw some enemies just shoot tears out when they died. This does in a with multiple tiers in multiple directions, though, and the tiers you have can affect that as well. Like the damage you do with your tiers, like I'm doing, you know, 4 damage right now. Those tiers do 4 damage, or relatively a 4 damage. I'm not sure what the multiplier of that actually is. But anyway, you see here, we're in womb 1. We are back in Mother's womb. We're returning to the place of our origin here. Try to wrap your head around that one. The Fallen. Well, it's nothing the Book of Belial can't handle. Oh. Wow, that was fast. Expecting him to shoot another blast at me. Like Krampus, he shoots a multi-area blast. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come at me, bro. Yep, there it is. And gore and blood and guts. This game is so violent. Wealth, but at what cost? I believe what that does is it gives you double the consumable items that appear at the end of a room. But it also increases the cost of getting what's referred to as a double trouble boss. And that's basically two of the same boss. In terms of health-wise, they're about the same. It's just basically like taking the boss and splitting him into two. But it increases the difficulty just because there's multiple enemies to have to face instead of one. Now in this case, we got more familiars. We've already got a kind of blood creep going right now with just walking around. But we don't. But we could use more multiple sources of tears. That's pretty cool. And we could get more blood creep with this one, but I think we're okay. Alright, that's our deal with the devil. I don't think we're going to get a chance at any more at this point, which might make getting Tammy's Head pretty worthwhile. That's a one-time shot. Doesn't do a whole lot of damage, though. The Book of Belial, I think in this case, is actually still more effective. So I think we'll just stick with it. Let's go back. I don't think we're really going to explore anymore. Yeah, I can't get to that. Can't fly. Flight is an important thing in this game. It can kind of break it in some ways, because often the game likes to put items in away from where you can get them. And you're going to have to fly in a lot of cases. Alright. Down the trapdoor. I don't think I saw that one to completion. That's pretty funny. Oh, we get another one that I didn't mention before. The Curse of the Lost. It basically removes your map. You can't see where you're going. There's another one that's really annoying called the Curse of the Labyrinth. And basically that's a chance to randomly teleport. You go through a door here to randomly put you in a room not... That was the one that was adjacent. So if you could see the map, I could show you what I'm talking about, but... Well, let's go to the arcade first. Arcade, something just kind of fun. Basically come in here. You gamble. There's usually like a slot machine. There's a guy here that does a shell game. And basically just gets you stuff at the cost of money. Here you can take damage to get more money. Unfortunately, really, you would only do that if you want to get more tries at, like, the slot machine with the shell game. Otherwise, it's not really worth it. There's a chance that you can get a health up item if you do it enough times. But you gotta hope that you do it enough or you're able to do it many times. Otherwise, nothing's really gonna happen. Ah, jeez. So, and you see, I had 2 soul hearts. Now I have 1. Missing poster. No idea what it does. We're gonna hold on to it and find out. Maybe it does something cool. Whoa, there's some weird sounds going on in here. Where are you? There you are. No, the shield does not protect me. It doesn't protect me from projectiles. I don't know why. What is the point of the shield? Oh, no, it does, I guess. Maybe. It's not very clear. Maybe it hurts enemies when they touch it. Now that we're here in the womb, basically after the fight with Mom, every area you go, basically every enemy is going to do a heart of damage, instead of in some cases where a single projectile would do like a half a heart. No, it's going to do a full heart, guaranteed. Ooh, poison shots, nice. I gotta watch these guys, because when they fart, they shoot stuff out. The weaker versions, these guys just push it back. No damage. But now they actually shoot stuff at you. And I'm completely lost right now. I'm going to use this room as a kind of focal point. Figure out where I'm at. You die now. And so do you. Alright, alright. It's getting rough here. Just trying to figure out where we're going. Hey. Don't you shoot that crap at me. Hey! Fine then, I'll stop shooting. Just pop that head out, buddy. You saw what happened. You too. Shoot that stuff at me. I dare you. See what happens. I get hit, that's what happens. I get hit again. Oh yeah, this is great. I get hit one more time and I'm dead. Fun run, everybody. But it's not over yet. And I have no way of checking to see if there were any hearts on the way back. Crap. Oh, we go up. No. Oh, we might need that battery later on. I believe we came this way. And there's that room there. We came up. There's the spikes. Don't get hit by the spikes. Oh, we checked the arcade. I believe we came this way. No, we didn't. That's not good. Bad dingle. Kill them, spiders. Thank God this helps, protects me. Shit, 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 shit. Oh, get away from me. Oh, that slowdown helped. Yes. Got him. Whew. That was scary. I got all these bombs. I'm going to start using them. Maybe we'll get some hearts popping up. Should also keep an eye out for, Oh, yeah, that's right. That was there. It's not looking good. Ooh, here we go. Just as I mentioned it. Some rocks have like a little X on them, and they're a little slightly discolored from the rest of the rocks. These rocks have good stuff in them. In this case, a spirit heart. Oh crap, we didn't want to go this way. But that's okay, these guys aren't all that tough. They're locked to the wall, and for some reason, I don't know why that's a thing. They're just attached to the wall. They don't do anything. I've yet to find out if I just simply leave them there, or if they just break free. But I'd rather not find out. No sense finding out. Don't even give the bastards a chance! Yeah! Oh boy. We're having fun now. Fortunately, these guys are not that tough. They're not terribly aggressive. They only shoot in one direction. And it's not terribly frequent. Enough to where you can just kinda jump in, get your shot off, jump out. Essentially, you can... you've probably been noticing while I've been playing, but while normally you just shoot in one direction, you can manipulate your shots, use a little momentum to make them fly in a certain direction. And it's a great way to hit enemies that are dangerous from a particular angle, and you just simply avoid it. Like, see there, draws my shots, I'm trying to keep out of his range and his spread. And oh, double hearts. I love it. That was amazing. That was so helpful. Oh, wow. That's a lot of keys. I'm the key master here. Very unnecessary, but you know what? I'll take it. And we're still looking for the boss room, and no such luck here. And we're getting out of that spot there. You'll look out. That's a slowdown all of a sudden. Hey. You need to die. Thank you. This is something new. Well, it's definitely not health down, so we're okay with whatever it is. Bad gas. A little pooping. I pooped myself there. I pooped him. Pooped your pants. Poop my pants. Nurse, I believe Mr. Stewart has pooped his pants. No, not again. What did we say about holding it in? Shoutouts to South Park. It's the best way I can... that was brilliant. It's the best way I can just keep myself entertained, just... spouting random lines from random TV shows. Oh man, we're basically gonna end up exploring just about every room here. Oh jeez, wow.
You gotta go.
Yep, just dance around these guys. Oh, okay, good. Heading down. And there's our boss room, finally! You need to die, because you keep coming close to me. I think it's possible maybe you can shoot that harness. And a heart, a key. More money we don't really need. Alright. Here we go. Boss time. It lives! Now normally, what you're looking at here is a heart. It's basically Mom's heart. Under normal circumstances. In this case though, it is a fetus. It's technically supposed to be Isaac, I believe. I think that's what the concept is. Some kind of weird like that. You're fighting yourself? Still in the womb? What's going on here? Oh, we got lucky there. Nice. That could have been bad. Alright. So as you can see, we've reached an interpass, I believe. Forgive me if that's not the word we're looking for. We basically hit a fork in the road here, and there's three paths we can take. Ultimately, though, I believe this path is the same as this path. Takes you down to the same place, I think. I could be wrong, though. However, this is the way up. And you know what? I just realized something silly. We had that second angel room, and I never attacked that angel. I did it again. I did a stream where I did that, and I had half a key, and nothing I could do with it. And that's kind of important, because when you come down here... Actually, not here specifically. Next area. After that. Shoal. Basically the depths. The darkest depths. Welcome to hell. Satan's domain. Yo, boy. Oh, man. Yeah, I'm getting my butt kicked here. You need to die. Whew. Give me hearts. Not what I asked for. Give me hearts. Damn you. The thing I need the most, they're not gonna give me. Go figure. Well, I got tons of bombs. Let's see if we can find secret rooms. Now, I want to apologize if there's anything I've been missing that I haven't been telling you guys. Just detail-wise. I mean, and just in terms of items and stuff like that. What's what? What does what? It's kind of like... Then you gotta find out for yourself. And our first tarot cards of the game, which is odd. Usually we get them a little bit sooner than this. But we got the double effect going, we got double the consumable that pops up, and then we get two hierophants. And, I believe... Yes! Spirit hearts. Good news to be had by all. And these guys... And I'm thinking the scythe is actually something you get from the horseman death. Just a guess. Because he actually, during the death fight, he summons something similar. And it's kind of a, I think it's a nod to the fights with the, whoa. Some rebounding tears here. But, yeah, I think it's a nod to the fights with death in the Castlevania series, where he summons all those, Hey, heart, nice. Where he summons all those scythes that attack you. Explosive thoughts. Basically, he's a bomb. And he goes out towards the direction you're shooting. Ooh, double shots, nice. Too bad we're not gonna be able to take advantage of that. But we get scythe shot again, I like it. I think it's just a spectral shot, which basically, no, maybe not. God damn, those guys. Oh, speed down? Wow, I don't think our speed can go any lower. Yikes. What do we got? Oh, these guys, I hate these things. Those guys are, oh, jeez, those guys are really annoying. Oh, back off, back off. Wow. They're all the way over there. Awesome, just simply awesome. Oh boy. Thank you. That helped. Oh jeez, do I want to try and find... Let's try. Nope. Try again. Nope. Gotta try the other side. But no. Nope. Oh, man. I'm beginning to think we're not gonna be able to find the secret room here. So we're just gonna have to go fight the boss. Satan himself. Book of Belial, don't fail me now. I'm gonna get scythe shot, too. Just a super cool effect. I don't know what it really does, but hey, you know what? We'll take it. It's cool. Hitting the devil with scythe. And here he comes. The man himself. Oh, wow. I didn't know he could do that. Jeez. He did it again, you bastard. Oh, man. Devil's tough. He really is. Oh god, not these guys. No. So it's true with a lot of fights like this, particularly when you have a boss that, like Mom or the Devil, that just basically, or Satan, I should say, that basically just, oh fuck, not these. These things spawning are really, really hurting me. No, back off. They need to go away. Gotcha. Whew. But basically the best thing to do in those kind of fights is just run around. Keep moving. Don't be a sitting target. Oh boy. So normally, once you have effectively the game decides you have beaten the game, and this happens the first time you fight Mom, when you first play the game, after you've unlocked Mom's heart, when you beat Mom's heart, and then after that, when you've unlocked Satan, when you beat him, and then effectively after all a number of other boss fights that have been unlocked, you'd get this giant chest. And when you open it up, you get a special ending. Mom's heart, I believe, as well as It Lives, the fetus, gives you special endings, and it unlocks special items that you get to use in future playthroughs. Whereas with the Devil, with Mom, I think with Mom's heart the first time, it's just a specific ending. It's a unique ending, tailored for that. But I believe in this case, we don't get an ending. No, we go even further down. Ooh, we hit by baseball, ouch. That's Charlie Browning right there. We're in the dark room. Now remember that key? That half key that I have that I forgot to get the other half? That's for this thing. And honestly, I forget what's behind this door. It's either a boss fight or it's a special item of some kind. But what's nice is we open these chests. Oh, really? Normally we get some good out of these chests. I don't like these pills here. What do we get? Telepills? Oh, wow. That's actually pretty bad, because we didn't get to see what was in those other chests. We only have two hearts. And we're facing a really annoying boss. There's three of them. Holy crap. And the damage I'm doing against them is pretty minimal. Wow. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Oh my god, it keeps going. It just tracked me down. I can't believe it. Oh, that's bad. Keep moving. Oh. Oh, jeez. Oh, this is so bad. Oh, man. I'm gonna be amazed with myself if I somehow survive this. I'm not expecting to, especially with that! But let's... Oh, we finally got one! Thank you, Bandage Girl, for killing him. We are one third of the way. Come on, you gotta die, you gotta die. But no, we don't want you to do that. That's really bad, you gotta die. Come on. Bandage Girl! Coming through in the end. Oh, no! No, 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 no. That's really bad, really bad, really bad. Yeah, this guy summons those bastards. It's not fun at all. Come on, come on. Yo. Come on! Kill him, Bandage Girl! Yes! Yeah, Bandage Girl! Alright. Wow! I don't know what that does. Mega Tears! Oh, wow. Really slow firing rate. Oh man, I think I know what that is, and I really don't like them. If I am correct in my assumption, and I might not be, I really don't want to take the risk. This item gives you what's called control tears. And essentially, that big ball you're seeing right now, I don't shoot it out of my eye anymore. It's just basically floating there, and I control it with the joystick. And it just moves around all over the place in any direction I want. You're probably thinking, wait a minute, that's a great. What's wrong with that? What's wrong with that is I really suck at controlling it. So I really don't want to try it. It's not worth it. Man, a fire rate on this. Oh. But the damage, very nice. I'm not doing a whole lot of damage to this guy, though. Oh, maybe not. Damn. Bandage girl did it for me. Ooh, dry baby. Dry baby's cool. If projectile hits him, there's a chance he'll do what's called the Necronomicon effect, and that's basically doing damage to all the enemies in the room. And you get this guy. Rotten. Bob's rotten head. It's basically a bomb. It's a reusable bomb. You just activate it and then shoot it. It goes boom. But I already got something like that, so I don't really need it. Okay, what do we got here? Speed down, we use that. Speed up. Let's get that speed up. And we're never picking that speed. Oh, get away from me. Bad troll bomb. Oh, God. Maybe pick it up. That's a really bad troll bomb because it actually homes in on you. Oh, what? God, I can't believe it. That brain bomb that I was shooting out killed me because I was too close to it when it went off. Oh, wow. I can't believe it. What a way to end this. What a way to end it. That's terrible. Man. Oh, I'm sorry, folks. I'm sorry we couldn't make it to the end. Brutal. Just brutal. And yeah, that's kind of the luck I have with Magdalene. I have mentioned this in a couple streams that I've done so far of this game. But basically, and why I say there's like a learning curve to this game, and unlocking stuff really helps because you get better stuff as you go, but when I first started off, like I got a victory with Isaac just to start unlocking stuff the first game I played. He's the only character you can play as, too, when you first start the game. But I started playing as Magdalene and Cain at some point, and I was accumulating, you see over there, onto the left, win streak, -2. Whenever you win, it resets to 1. And each time you win in a row, as a streak is, it shows that number 2 times, 3 times, and so on. But when you die, it pays attention to how many times you die in a row as well. And I got to a point where, using Magdalene and Cain, I got like 20-plus death streaks, negative win streaks in a row. It was just really bad. It was really frustrating. But I finally figured out this game. I was finally, with Cain, able to beat Mom's Heart and the Devil in one run. I believe. Can't be wrong. With Magdalene, though, it was kind of frustrating because I had a lot of times where I was beating the Heart and I couldn't proceed further because I wasn't getting the Devil Room. And until you get to that point where you have that multiple paths you can take, the only way to progress further in even further in the game is to get a deal with the Devil during Mom's Heart. And I wasn't getting it, so the game ended right there with Mom's Heart, and I won, got endings, but I couldn't go any further. I wasn't skill enough, so I couldn't see the real ending, you know? It's like, you want to see the real ending, you beat it on hard mode, or you do something special. I wasn't getting that. Again, really sorry, folks, that we weren't able to actually beat the game. Despite beating all those bosses, we got really far. But in the end, it was all for naught. And as you can see here, I have, you see the icons over on the left change depending on the character I pick. Those are basically kind of milestones. It's which bosses you've beaten. And it first starts popping up with Mom's Heart. You can see the heart up there. You can see the little star there. That's a specific boss, I think. I can't remember which. But then the upside down cross is Satan. And then the, I think the thing in the bottom right there is supposed to be a picture. You get that? You see here with the Azazel, I got over on the left, it's a cross the right way, which means I beat the holy boss, the good guy boss. I forget what he was, in all honesty. I really can't remember. But Azazel's interesting. You see every character has different starting stats. Isaac is the basic. 2 attack, 2 speed, 3 hearts. Magdalene starts with 4. She also has the Yum Heart, which kind of counts as 5 every now and then. Replenishing your health, but she's slower than the majority of characters. Got Kane. Only 2 hearts, but 2 speed and 2 fight. It also starts with the Lucky Foot, which is basically lucky and increases the odds of you getting good stuff and when you gamble, which is slot machines and the shell game and other such things. Judas, oh, he's like a glass cannon, basically. One hit, one heart. But he starts with the Book of Belial, getting the damage boost and guaranteed boss, guaranteed devil rooms. Then you got this guy, who I believe is called Blue Boy. And you see that negative heart down there. It basically means he doesn't start with heart containers. He starts with spirit hearts, or soul hearts. He can gain heart containers as the game goes, but he starts off with none. So it's kind of cool, but kind of risky. And he starts with the poop, which as far as I know is pretty useless. It's basically a usable item and you generate poop. I guess it hurts enemies is all it really does. And then you got Eve, who is difficult to play with early on because she only does one. She only starts off with 1 damage, and then 2 hearts and 2 speed. And then she's got the dead bird, which basically, when you get hit, the bird comes out and it's a familiar that attacks enemies. And the Whore of Babylon, which is for all of the characters. When you're down to half of a heart, it activates and basically gives you a damage boost and a speed boost. But for Eve, it's only when she has 1 heart left instead of half a heart. So you can kind of manipulate it in a way to where if you have 1 heart container and then you have a bunch of spirit hearts or black hearts, which you actually never ran into in this run with Magdalene. It's surprising. You usually get at least 1. But black hearts, once they're depleted, they actually do damage to all the enemies in the room. But you can manipulate Eve in a way that you can get a bunch of soul hearts and have a single heart container and have Whore of Babylon going all the time, just perpetually. Never goes out until you get yourself another heart container. You can even lose all your heart containers and have nothing but spirit hearts and still have that effect going. It's kind of cool. I've had that happen several times, but it never really panned out for anything. I think mostly because the items I got weren't all that good. Sam said I've never tried yet. I'm gonna try him someday. Lazarus, I'm not sure what his deal is, as opposed to Isaac. Same stats, but I'm not sure what he starts off with. And then Eden's interesting. Eden, you just get random stats and I think a random item or two. But you can see down there it says Eden tokens, which is 15. That means that's the max number of times you can play as Eden. You get more as you beat Mom's Heart. But yeah, it's like playing an arcade machine or something. You only get so many uses. But Eden's interesting. I've only played as Eden once, and I got pretty decent. And then there's Azazel. Azazel's really cool. He's similar to Blue Boy, where he starts off with only spirit hearts, but he's got good speed, he's got good damage, he can also fly, which is so huge in the game. So huge. And at the same time, he doesn't have tears. He has a that stream shot that you saw a number of enemies shooting at me with, though its range is really limited. Basically, the distance it goes is between, equivalent to, between Azazel and Samson, right there. And I don't think the range ever increases. But it's still really cool. Because it's damage over time. Basically, as long as the stream's going, enemies can just get hit and hit and hit. Really nice. There's probably a lot more I can talk about, and I think I'll just save it for future runs, but I think that's about it. That's The Binding of Isaac. A very fun game, a game that the moment became available, the Rebirth, I really wanted to get it and try it out with all the runs that I've seen of it. And it's been frustrating, but ultimately it's been a lot of fun. And I highly recommend it if you don't mind some of the stuff you see in it, such as a lot of the violence and other mature material. Like, see there in the corner, just underneath the eye in Isaac, you see a guy, a little stick figure with a sword or something, cutting off the head of another stick figure. Just random little stuff like that. But if you can handle that, I highly recommend this game. But just be ready for some frustration early on, because randomization is the key of this game. And the whole trick to being able to beat it is dealing with what you get and making the best of it and learning the best way to play as your character and figuring out how all the items work, really. Because there's no way of knowing. You can look up facts online and they'll tell you, but just playing the game purely, you don't get much of a idea. A lot of the items will give you something cryptic in terms of what it does, amongst other things. And I believe it's right now about $20 on Steam. The original, if you want to play, which I believe there's a number of changes that were made from this game to the previous. The original is only $5. So if you just want to try that one out for cheap, just to see if you like the feel of the game. But I recommend Rebirth mostly, because I believe there's a lot of good changes that were made for Rebirth. Including stuff like frame rate. It doesn't have issues with lag as much, and I believe there aren't as many issues with crashing. I'm not sure about all the details, but I heard that there were a number of problems with the original that were fixed for Rebirth. And just ultimately, it's a really fun game. So go get it. Get it now! So this has been my run of The Binding of Isaac. Hope to do more in the future. In the meantime, I'm out. Thank you for watching. I'm Jesse Lockhart. Peace out, y'all. Night.